Almost 23 years after Lockheed Martin secured the Joint Strike Fighter contract, the Pentagon declared on March 12th that the F-35 has received approval to commence full-rate production. The F-35A has been operational with the Air Force since 2016. While the designation may seem somewhat inconsequential, as the F-35 production enterprise is already operating near its capacity, it signifies that the Joint Program Office is now able to engage in negotiations for multi-year contracts for the fighter. The service continues to pursue a planned fleet of 1,763 aircraft. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. is surging ahead in the fifth-generation fighter race with full-rate production approval for the F-35. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. William LaPlante, the Pentagon's acquisition executive, signed the acquisition decision memorandum greenlighting Milestone C, denoting full-rate production. This approval came after a March 7th gathering of the Defense Acquisition Board, a committee he presides over. The Defense Department said in a press release that he made the call after considering the results from F-35 operational test and evaluation, live fire testing, the system development and demonstration exit criteria, applicable laws, and future production strategy. The release noted that production to full rate requires control of the manufacturing process, acceptable performance and reliability, and the establishment of adequate sustainment and support systems. LaPlante called the milestone a major achievement for the F-35 program, highlighting for the military services, international partners, and FMS customers that the F-35 is stable and agile, and that all statutory and regulatory requirements have been appropriately addressed. LaPlante said the F-35 status means it's now well-positioned to efficiently produce and deliver. He praised the efforts of Program Director Air Force Lieutenant General Michael Schmidt and the Joint Program Office, saying the program has made significant improvements over the last decade, and we will always be driven to continuously improve sustainability, interoperability, and lethality of the fighter. The program can now focus on the future of the F-35 instead of the past. He called the fighter the premier system that drives interoperability with our allies and partners while contributing to integrated deterrence and the precepts of the National Defense Strategy. Greg Ulmer, the Executive Vice President for Aeronautics at Lockheed, has predicted that the F-35 program is poised to maintain a consistent production rate, targeting approximately 156 aircraft per year for the next 5 years at least. The Pentagon stated that for the last 4 years, the full-rate decision was hindered by difficulty integrating the F-35 with the Joint Simulation Environment, or JSE, a wargaming system that helps decision-makers find the right mix of platforms and weapons for given war scenarios. Testing in the JSE was a prerequisite for the F-35 to complete IOT&E. That hurdle was cleared in September 2023. The Pentagon noted the F-35 program has delivered more than 990 aircraft to the U.S. military services, partners, and FMS customers. While the F-35 program didn't go smoothly, the U.S. is making rapid progress when it comes to deploying fifth-generation fighters. Sukhoi Su-57 is Russia's answer to F-22 and F-35, Russian President Vladimir Putin revealed that a procurement plan is being laid out for acquiring 76 Su-57. The announcement was made during a meeting on May 15, 2019. These jets are expected to be deployed by 2028. The Kremlin previously planned to have 150 of these aircraft in service by 2020, but only 30 have been built till now. The Kremlin has been struggling to fulfill many defense acquisitions due to funding constraints, and the Ukraine war has added to this issue. Also, while Su-57 is meant to be stealthy, it has an RCS of 0.05 square meters, which makes it around 500 times larger on the radar when compared to F-22, and at least 10 times when compared to F-35. Chengdu J-20, also known as Mighty Dragon, is a twin-jet all-weather fighter aircraft developed by China's Chengdu Aerospace Corporation for the People's Liberation Army Air Force, PLAAF. The aircraft is supposed to counter the American stealth fighters. Some reports suggest that around 250 of these have been built, which is a good number, but the aircraft is still not a finished product, and many critical components are being changed. In October 2023, the Pentagon reported that PLAAF was preparing upgrades for the J-20, including extended weapon-carrying capability, thrust vectoring nozzles, control systems for unmanned aircraft teaming, and WS-15 high-thrust engines. The fighter also has several inherent issues with stealth profile, and some experts have suggested that the J-20 is nothing more than a decorated 4++ generation fighter. The U.S. military-industrial base has experience with stealth. F-22 and B-2 are well known for their low observable characteristics. F-35 is a true, stealthy, fifth-generation fighter, unlike its rivals. Sensor fusion and situational awareness in F-35 are also at the next level. For example, the Distributed Aperture System, DAS, in F-35 can detect and track ballistic missiles at ranges exceeding 800 miles or 1,300 kilometers. And has also demonstrated the ability to detect and track multiple small suborbital rockets simultaneously in flight. There is already a significant number of F-35 deployed with the U.S. Air Force, and the new lots will boost the number dramatically. This is also good news for the partner nations and seems to be a win-win situation. So it can be said that the F-35 program is well ahead when compared to its Russian and Chinese counterparts. F-35s, combined with F-22 Raptor, will give the U.S. Air Force an edge both in terms of quality as well as quantity. This basically means the U.S. Air Force will continue to dominate the skies in the foreseeable future.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.